to you. He gon' give it to you. He's gon' give it to you. He gon' give it to you. First you gonna start, then we gonna. What is going on, guys? My name is Suti here. Welcome to this FIFA 17 defending tutorial. It's my fourth tutorial on defending. That's because I think defending is just as important as attacking. Look at those goals conceded, guys. If you concede that few goals per match, winning is gonna become easy. Only open 38 goals conceded per match on FIFA 16. And that's why this is another defending tutorial for you guys. This time on how to defend on the wings. I've showed you already how to apply high pressure, how to defend on the box. I've showed you the most important defending techniques. But in here we're gonna really focus on how we specifically defend on the wings. We're gonna use some advanced methods and really break it down. We're gonna see how to trap opponents and defend 2v1 on the wings. Also how to just defend by yourself in a 1v1 situation and defending players who are cutting inside. Let's go, guys. For an amazing FIFA 17 squad, link is in the description for cheap and safe coins. And do you want to play against me? Get a gameplay analysis for personal FIFA lessons. Link is also in the description. Let's start with my favorite techniques on the wing, but this is not always possible, so make sure to hang in there for other situations. Basically, the two directions we want to block is block the direction forward and the direction inside. And you always have to select the player who can protect the center. That's the guy in the green circle. You press and hold the R1 or RB button, that guy will block the option forward. But as you can see, we ourselves always select the guy who can block the center, the one in the yellow circle. And if your opponent is gonna cut inside, you can block the center. I've paused it here because I want to show you something important. Defending on the wing is amazing. We can easily trap opponents there because of the sideline. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tempt the opponent to pass it to the sideline. What did I just do? I'm blocking the center and now the opponent has to go to the sideline. Of course, he's the one deciding, but really it is me telling him, yo mate, you should go to the sideline, go over there. And look at that, he does it indeed, and in the end he ends up getting trapped on the sideline. Indeed, he cannot go down, there is the sideline. He cannot go left, he cannot go up, he was trapped. We always want to force our guys to the sideline and then we can trap him with the overplay aside technique. Here we try to do it again, but if you look very carefully, he's still not really trapped. He could still go back. So what I'm gonna do in this situation with James Rodriguez, I'm gonna move him a little bit more to the right, and now Robin can also not even turn back anymore. So this is a trick you can always sometimes use. Instead of only blocking the center, you can always also block that he cannot turn back. And as said, if he cuts inside, you can block it with the player you're controlling. And if he keeps running forward, then the other player will block it for you. The one you need to hold R1 on the PlayStation, that's RB on Xbox. And if he keeps running forward, then the CPU will fix it for you. If he cuts inside, you will fix it. Okay, overplaying sides is amazing, but we can't always do it. Sometimes we only have one player, and what you need to do then is use jockey movement while you are diagonally between the goal and the center. This time we have to block both the option forward and the option to the center with one player. We cannot overplay sides with one player, therefore this time we need to position ourselves diagonally between the goal and the center. We need to block both directions. Also make sure to not keep tracking him here with Marcelo here, you won't catch up with him. You need to select the center back, move him out on the wing, sprint to him, but once you get close, you're gonna jockey diagonally between the goal and the center. That's how they defend them 1-on-1, guys. First sprint close and only then use jockey movement when close. Let's see now how we can protect our center against opponents who are gonna cut inside from the wing. Basically what you need to do is always again select a guy who can protect the center. Don't select a guy who's closest to your opponent. If you think he's gonna cut inside, you need to select a player who can protect the center. And this is the great thing, if you have good defending, it's gonna result in good goals as well. And here we're gonna do the same thing again. I'm gonna be a little bit over aggressive, but right now you need to think, switch to Marcelo. I need a guy who can protect the center. I do not want to get disorganized and track him with Carvajal. I need a guy who can protect the center, and that is how you can protect yourself against opponents who are gonna cut inside from the wing. Here again, they pass it out to the wing, and once they cut inside, you need to switch to Pepe. Don't keep tracking him with Benzema in this case, you won't catch up with him. You're gonna disorganize your entire defense. Once he's gonna cut inside, we select a player below him, so we are gonna make sure that we can block him when he's gonna sprint inside. So make sure to not keep tracking them with your fullbacks or with your left or right midfielder. Switch players, think ahead, and switch to someone who can protect the center. Alright, so how to defend on the wing if it's close to the box already. I showed you this in my how to defend on the box tutorial a little already, but in this situation we are not gonna overplay sides, we're gonna do back covering. We are gonna jockey behind that player while holding the R1 or RB button, and you can see the opponent has no clue what he needs to do to beat these two guys. There is no way he's gonna beat two guys in a row there. What you can also do often, what I do, is call that second mate for teammate support. I don't like defending 1v1. I'm calling him for support, and once he's there, then I'm gonna jockey behind him. I do not like defending 1v1, it's way too risky. I'm gonna call for support with that button, and once he's there, I'm gonna jockey behind him. Call for support, jockey behind him yet again. I don't like defending 1v1 at all. Call for support again, I'm gonna jockey behind him, and this is why jockeying behind him is important. If the opponent turns, the AI will be beaten, and that is why you need to be there to cut him off. Look at that, he turns, he beats the AI, but we are there to cut him off, and in the end we are gonna jockey behind him again. We're gonna move things to the other side and things are gonna get fixed. Make sure to drop a like if you enjoyed, subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. My name is Suti, see you next time.